Welcome everybody, today I'm going to show you my original series tricorder build. This project started back in 2017 with rigor, punctuated with some long delays. Then with the pandemic in 2020, gave me the time to continue and complete the project. I began by gutting out a Diamond Select tricorder I purchased on Amazon and rebuilt it with some aluminum parts from a gentleman named Russell Harrell. The Wand Company is soon coming out with their tricorder, and I'm super excited about this. From what I understand on the website, I am sure theirs will look a thousand times better and have really cool functionality. I'm definitely going to purchase one because I would like to see the differences between what I built and what they came out with. I think it would be fun to compare the two, and maybe I'll do another video when I get one in my hands. Originally, I was going to use a Raspberry Pi Zero and use the original buttons, but I eventually gave up on this because the wiring became just too extreme and I kept burning out the I2C and the audio channels. Ultimately, I decided to use the Adafruit Pi Portal and Clue to negate the buttons altogether. For the handheld device, I'm using an SGP30 gas sensor connected to an Adafruit Itsy Bitsy. As you can see, I can connect the Itsy Bitsy to the Bluefruit app on my phone to receive the gas sensor data. The Bluefruit app sends that data via mqtt to Adafruit IO, and the Pi Portal retrieves that information from Adafruit IO via mqtt within the code. The handheld device was fun to build, though it was a very tiny space to work with. I jammed everything in there pretty well, but everything works beautifully. Since the case is plastic, the Bluetooth passes through freely. On the opposite side of the handheld, I have a little charging port to recharge the battery. Here we have the main switch that turns on both the Adafruit Clue and the Pi Portal. Inside is a large 3000 milliamp per hour lithium battery and an Adafruit 5-volt mini boost to make sure everything has the proper power. On the Clue, you see a Moire animated GIF created by CompaniaHill from the Fleet Workshop. A big thank you to him, as it is a beautiful addition. Next we have the temperature in Celsius, and then we have atmospheric pressure in Pascals. Next is the humidity, and then the ambient light sensor. We can also use the colorimeter to get color information on small objects. The volume is not in decibels, but in some other format. An acceleration is measured in three dimensions, four if you include time. The gyroscope is also displayed in three or four dimensions. The magnetometer displays in three dimensions and is quite sensitive. Finally, we have the Adafruit AMG 8833 IR thermal camera representing temperature and gradated colors. A big thank you to notSpock for integrating the IR camera and Moire GIF into the Clue sensor plotter example. The only thing I don't like about the IR camera is that it has about a 3-foot range. It would be nice if the range were closer to 20 feet or so. Now we move up to the Adafruit Pi Portal, and as you can hear, it has a nice Trek boot up sound, and I tried to make it look as Star Trek as possible. Excuse me if it looks a little inauthentic, but I did the best I could. The first screen displays the gas sensor data via MQTT from Adafruit IO. As you can see, the numbers change as the gas readings change. The second screen is just a placeholder, as I don't have any other sensors aside from the third screen, but it is a little fun subspace graph that shows whatever subspace is in graph form. Finally, we have the third screen showing the distance sensor and the unit temperature. The distance sensor is a Garmin LiDAR Lite optical LED version 4. A big thank you to the folks at Adafruit Support, specifically Dave, who actually had to rewrite the library file to get this version to work. The sensor shows distances up to about 32 feet. This is represented in centimeters, but at some point I'd like to display it in meters. But that's not a priority. The unit temp was originally displayed in Celsius, but I was able to convert it into Kelvin with a few decimal point place accuracy. The fit and finish of the project begins with the aluminum replacement pieces. I had to redesign and 3D print the compartment that holds the Clue. Also, I milled aluminum round bar to recreate the data disks on the left of the Clue. I cut holes on the back for the IR camera and the Garmin sensors. On the bottom of the tricorder, I included a charging port to recharge the lithium ion battery. To create the handheld device compartment, I cleaned up the wiring and covered the battery and compartment with Kinso high temperature automotive tape. To keep the handheld device in place, I installed some packing foam. To accommodate the Pi portal, I milled some aluminum flat bar, negating the physical buttons. I 3D printed a template and used a router with a carbide bit to mill out the main screen and the speaker holes. I hope you enjoyed watching this video. If you have any questions, please leave it in the comments below. I'd be happy to answer any questions you may have. Also, I have links down below for the Arduino and CircuitPython code, as well as for the products that I use in this project. Thanks for watching, and give me a thumbs up if you like the video.